What is going on YouTube? Hidden Back making another brand new crypto TV episode. In today's video, we're going to be looking at Uniswap, Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP. If we have time, the S&P 500. Another thing we're going to be talking about is Pionex. For those that don't remember, back at the end of January, we discussed a Bitcoin and cryptocurrency bot trading software, an automated trading software that allowed us to basically just buy in and let the bots trade out and see how much profit we created. It's been a while since we reviewed it last, and I want to show you guys an updated video. I know a lot of you guys have been asking me. I know some of you guys are probably going to be surprised by the profits, but I just want to show you what that is. And then furthermore, to discuss what we're going to be looking at in today's video, XRP has actually managed to explode up 20% out of our pennant flag that we've been tracking for weeks now, has finally reached its apex, and we're seeing a major pop to the upside. So I'm extremely excited to discuss this with you, share the profits, share the gains. Otherwise, if you guys are new to the channel, definitely make sure to subscribe, turn on post notifications, leave a giant thumbs up as this does help support the YouTube algorithm. Make sure to follow me on Twitter at CryptoVOfficial. This way, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, you could DM me over there. Otherwise, let's jump right into today's episode. So honestly, I don't even know where to begin. Looking at the past two videos that we've put out, we've basically been honing in on this massive pennant flag that's been forming. We've been seeing literally since 2 days ago, the XRP Ripple holders should hurry because there's literally a few days left to get in. And then yesterday we discussed there's a few days left, don't panic. We're pretty much at the end of the apex and we should be seeing a confirmation pump any minute now. So moving on to actually XRP, you can see what exactly is happening and I'm extremely excited. Check this out. You can see on the price range right here, we've managed to explode literally over 20%. I mean, we can put this right here and pull this down a little bit lower and you can see from the jump, it's about a 22% gain from where we started at that pennant flag. We've seen this coming. We had these lower highs pretty much pushing the coin down. 1, 2, 3, we have 4 right here. We have our higher low with 1, 2, 3. And finally, we had the confirmation. We discussed yesterday in grave detail, I remember, that the second we saw confirmation of a break above this resistance, if we closed the daily candle, which we were looking at, and yesterday it did not do so, above the resistance of 46 cents, we would know that that is a key confirmation to buy in anticipation for a swing to the upside. I mean, I don't even know where to begin. We saw last night, if not earlier today, a major confirmation. Not only did we break through our resistance, but we broke above 46 cents. I mean, maybe I jumped the gun, but the second I saw confirmation of a 46 cent break, that's when I bought in. So I am in this market currently. I know we've receded a little bit from where we were, but we were up quite a bit. And although I have yet to put in a stop loss, which I plan on doing later today, I do believe we are going to be swinging back up. As I did say yesterday and days prior that the target would be closer to 54 cents, there's a massive mouth to this pennant flag, and I do believe we're going to be headed up higher. So I have currently bought in. If I was to set a stop loss, which I might do, I'd set it closer maybe to 45 cents, right where the red band is on the moving average. But I do believe we are going to be headed up much higher in the very near future, maybe today, maybe tomorrow. Now, I'm no financial advisor. Definitely take my information with a grain of salt. But if, let's say, I haven't yet bought in already, maybe this video comes out at 10 or 11 a.m. in the morning, I do think it would be prime and not a bad position to be getting in closer to 47, maybe 48 cents, because I do believe we are going to be seeing this price slowly swing back up to 53 cents as that target level. So if you haven't bought in already, this might be an opportunity to take advantage of. If you have bought in, I definitely make sure to hodl strong, create a stop loss just to cover your tracks in case this just turns out terrible and we flip to the downside. Put one probably closer to, I'd say, 45 cents. But from where I bought in at 46, we are looking very good. And I do believe we looked even better, honestly, from the swing we had all the way to 52 cents. But I do believe we're going to head back up there and we're going to head even higher. So target is set. We're looking for a 54 cent retest again. Just increase your stop losses, eat those overnight fees. I know they're very tiny on BitYard, but it's definitely something I recommend. I mean, things are huge happening right now for XRP and for, even Bitcoin too. But we saw a massive confirmation price shot up, extraordinarily high. I'm very, very, very happy to see this massive swing. I know a ton of you guys have taken advantage already, DMing me, messaging me on Patreon, even on my Discord that we have set up on Patreon, so definitely check that out. But huge runs to the upside are happening right now, and honestly, a lot of people are leveraging, you know, XRP and capitalizing off this market by a, you know, a boatload. So definitely make sure to check out BitYard if you haven't already. They do offer a demo account as well, which you can test your skills. But I did link BitYard in the description, and I definitely recommend checking it out, as I do believe this is the one of the key, you know, trading platforms, especially for people within the US, within New York. This is probably one of the best ones I've used that I found that actually supports US customers. So definitely make sure to check that out. Now moving on to, you know, other cryptos, once again, XRP, I just can't, I'm fascinated by the massive pump that finally happened at the end of this pennant flag. The confirmation that we've all been waiting for is finally happening today. But looking at these other coins, I mean, Ethereum looks okay. It could be a lot better, honestly. I mean, yesterday did close above the uptrend, which is what we wanted, but today opened at a fairly low price. So I'm really kind of, you know, worried about Ethereum right now. If we close below here, like we're kind of doing, like if nothing changes and tonight we close where we are and tomorrow we open right here, I'm going to swing to a bearish, you know, a bearish signal, and I would consider the market start to correct lower. And I don't really want to see that, but it's definitely a big possibility. So I'm really hoping that today we can, you know, kind of correct back up and get back above the uptrend before we see, you know, lower drops to, you know, the moving average, which I really don't want to see. Now for Bitcoin, this is interesting. I just want to pull it up on BitYard real quick. You can see Bitcoin actually corrected back down. We're trading at its, I believe this is the 10-day moving average, which is okay. Hopefully we can bounce off this and correct higher. I mean, we did just recently hit all-time highs and corrected lower. Now, I'm not too worried about the way this chart looks. This is Bitcoin on its 4-hour, and I want to show you guys something. Multiple times in the past, we've actually fallen below prior supports. I mean, we could probably tweak this a little bit, just like this, and you can see how it kind of works right now. Now we have, you know, support. This is actually supporting it. We have here a support level, so we have the three confirmations that we need. So it honestly, you know, Bitcoin doesn't really look too bad. I do think that the consolidation is definitely needed for the coin, and I do think hopefully we pump up higher. Hopefully we can use this uptrend and the 4-hour moving average to swing ourselves back up and eventually retest 58,000. The prior all-time high, which is currently set at 62K right now. But I do think that with a little bit of time, hopefully it should bounce off support and swing up higher. Now with this slight correction on Bitcoin, I do believe we can continue to use this as an uptrend. And like we said about XRP, the second we see confirmation above the green band, we know to buy in. If we see confirmation close above resistance, we know, or support, we know to buy in for a short. Same thing applies itself with Bitcoin. If at any point this coin decides to dud and we close below this, you know, support level and uptrend right here in the 4-hour moving averages, good chance we're going to see a dump. I don't want to see it, but it's definitely a possibility. We're doing good right now. We're, you know, creating these higher lows over and over again. And this is allowing the coin to swing up higher and higher every single day. And hopefully can continue to use this support to eventually swing back up. So honestly, next target I would say for Bitcoin is closer to $58,000, probably by March 19th. That is about 3 days, so I'm not too worried. But I do believe in about 3 days, we should be able to see a close retest of $58,000. As for Uniswap, it's in the same boat, retesting bottom support. Now, notice with this uptrend, it's not exact on the green band. There's been multiple days where we've fallen below to retest our 4-hour support, but we've pretty much confirmed that and have used that. We're pretty darn low on the 4-hour. We're pretty much oversold now on the 4-hour, and we need to start to swing back up. So I do believe this this support level of the uptrend, the 4-hour moving average, all, you know, aligning right here, we should be able to see a bounce. So I do think Uniswap also looks pretty good as a good buy-in opportunity. Now, I don't want to spend too much time on all these other cryptocurrencies or on all these cryptos, because I do want to talk about Pionex and the S&P 500. But real quick, to wrap up the S&P 500, we have officially broken through our all-time high back in this game, or back inside our ascending fractal, which is great news if you ask me. We've consolidated, we've done our, you know, our consolidation, and we've allowed ourselves more room to swing up higher. So I'm very thrilled to see the S&P 500 move back up. Now to wrap up Pionex, the For those that don't know Pionex, this is what it looks like. We've talked about this. This is a exchange order book where you can use bot trading as well as, you know, other trading softwares on the platform, leveraging and stuff like that. But the main feature that they advertised on Pionex was the fact that they offer, bot trading. And I kind of want to share with you guys how that looks. I mean, you can already see it on the screen, but this is back since, you know, January. This has been months now. So honestly, you know, we started with, I think, $1,000, and this is the profit we've made, $85. I mean, is it great? Sure. Is it, you know, something to be like proud of? Probably not. I mean, look at when we started this. Just to scroll back in our profit right here. We started this right here, January 19th, and it just made another position March 16th today. So we've had probably close to 2 months now, 8 weeks of letting these bots trade itself with a $400 investment on each. So $800 invested over two different bots. And the only thing we were able to make is $30 pretty much on this one, on the arbitrage bot, and then like $60 or $50 on the other one. I think it's 50. The grid trading bot got us $51 in profit. So maybe I'm doing something wrong. Maybe I played it extremely conservative, but for 2 months of investment into a market where prices have literally shot from Bitcoin back in January 19th, let's just do some quick thinking here. January 19th was all the way back here. Not even farther. God damn. Let's go all the way back. January 19th was right, I'd say right around here. So January 19th, the price of the coin was $34,000. So we've practically doubled. It means if you put in $34,000 into Bitcoin, or let's say you put, I don't know, $500 into Bitcoin. Let's say you put the $800 that we've done, we would be up at $1,600 now. We would have doubled our profit just by leaving it in this coin, into Bitcoin, for the same time period. So, I mean, it seems like Pionex is making more money than it's sharing. So I'm not a huge fan of it, but let me know in the comments down below what you think. Otherwise, it's pretty much going to wrap up today's video. Definitely make sure to subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in tomorrow's episode. Peace.